Hello, Cloud Gurus. My name is Tim Berry, and I'm pleased to welcome you to another GCP this month for May 2020. We're all adjusting to our new way of working, but it hasn't stopped Google Cloud from releasing plenty of new products, service updates, and partner announcements. The month of May has brought us new features for Compute Engine, Kubernetes Engine, and even something called VMware Engine. There's lots of great stuff to talk about, so let's make it so. So let's start with some breaking news. Google has finally announced Google Cloud Next 20 on air. After sadly cancelling the in-person event in San Francisco, then postponing the original announcement of Cloud Next on air, the event is finally confirmed as a 9-week digital event series. That's right, 9 weeks. 9 weeks of GCP talks and sessions online. Do you get some sort of cert for watching all 9 weeks? Each week, we'll focus on a specific topic and feature keynotes, sessions, and interactive developer programs. And best of all, everything is available for free. If you were already registered for Cloud Next, then you're already signed up. But if not, you can register on the Next On Air website today. Okay, Cloud Gurus, let's jump into our GCP Quick Bites. First up, some Compute Engine updates. Compute Engine instances are now shielded by default. Shielded VMs have been available for just over a year and provide additional security features like verifying the bootloader and kernel, and they're now the default instance type for your peace of mind. And you can combine this with the OS patch management service announced by my good buddy Matthias last month for additional peace of mind. Pieces of mind? Peace of minds? Windows Server Containers on GKE, also announced last month, are now GA with full ecosystem support. So if you really want to run Windows in a container, I guess now you can. And AMD EPYC-based N2D VM instances are now available with up to 224 vCPUs. How epic is that? Next, we've got some big updates for big data. Not medium data, not small data. Don't even get me started with your tiny data. I'm only interested in big data updates. Data Catalog is now GA. This is a new fully managed service for cataloging and managing business and technical metadata. But what does that actually mean? Data Catalog aggregates all of your metadata from BigQuery, PubSub, and Cloud Storage into a centralized catalog to provide a single place for data discovery. For organizations with a growing number of data assets, Data Catalog can provide a self-service portal for finding the right data. It can auto-tag PII data using the Cloud Loss Prevention API, and it even supports ingesting metadata from non-Google sources using community connectors. BigQuery now features materialized views in beta, which improve performance and reduce costs by periodically pre-computing and caching query results. There's also updates to BigQuery scripting and stored procedures with new exception handling, JDBC and ODBC support, and federated ORC and Parquet queries from Cloud Storage are now supported. Oh, and the Video Intelligence API now supports logo recognition in GA. That's kind of big data-y, isn't it? Finally, Google continues to expand its integrated partner services with a new managed Apache Cassandra service from DataStax. Secret Manager, which I first mentioned back in January, is now GA. There are new Web Application Firewall or WAF capabilities in Cloud Armor for both cloud and on-prem services. And Google Meet is now free for everyone. Meet is Google's business video conferencing system, which allows up to 100 participants to awkwardly talk all over each other for up to 60 minutes, although that time limit won't actually be enforced until the end of September. Google are championing the safety and security features of Google Meet over its rivals, so it looks like you've got one more piece of software to explain to your grandparents. Okay, Cloud Gurus, that's enough quick bites to form several large meals in my opinion, so let's move on to our GCP Gems. There are some really interesting announcements I want to dig a bit deeper into this month. The first is the release of the Anthos sample deployment on the GCP marketplace. It's fair to say that Anthos has been a bit tricky for the marketing department at Google, and lots of people are still a bit confused about what Anthos actually is. Google Cloud earned itself a reputation of creating singular, industry-leading products that do what they say on the tin: cloud storage, cloud SQL, cloud DNS. Then suddenly, we get this thing called Anthos, and it's not even a product. It's a bunch of products and services all rolled into a subscription fee. So to help dispel some of this confusion, Google have launched the Anthos sample deployment, which you can launch straight from the Google Cloud Marketplace. This will create a new GCP project containing demonstrations of key Anthos components and a tutorial to follow along to help you understand them. The deployment contains a certified Kubernetes cluster, service mesh, dashboard tools such as SLO and performance monitoring, and configuration management tools set up with a GitOps workflow to keep the production state stored under version control. Anthos is getting some serious enterprise hybrid cloud love at the moment, including from the US Department of Defense. And right now, Google are letting people explore the features of Anthos free of charge for up to 100 vCPUs per month until the end of June 2020. Just to be clear, the free part of that is the Anthos service fee. You still have to pay for any infrastructure costs like compute engine or storage. But if your organization needs a modern hybrid cloud container solution like Anthos, it's a great time to check it out. My next GCP gem this month is Google's newly announced architecture framework. Now, it's not an exciting new service or cutting-edge product. It is basically a bunch of docs. But sometimes a bunch of docs is exactly what you need. Google's Cloud Architecture Framework is an extensive set of documents that contain Google's operational knowledge of running massively scaled distributed systems securely, efficiently, and reliably. And I mean it's extensive, with sections on resource management, identity and access management, networking, storage, databases, analytics, you name it. Now, you may already understand a lot of these principles from reading the individual docs from GCP products, but this framework brings them all together and combines them with guidance for operational excellence. This includes strategies for release engineering, automation, disaster recovery, and security. If you're looking to use GCP for a new project, you could use the framework to help you discover how the various pieces fit together to build solutions. Or maybe you need to evaluate and review existing infrastructure against these best practices. There's no denying it's a huge tome of information, but the best cloud architects out there will want to absorb all of it so they can offer the best solutions to their clients. I wouldn't be surprised to see some GCP partners offer reviews against this framework as a service. So how's this for a GCP gem? Google have just launched Cloud VMware Engine. CEO Thomas Kurian continues his ongoing mission to conquer the enterprise market by bringing the complete VMware experience, including vSphere, vCenter, vSAN, and all those other VMware acronyms, to an integrated first-party offering inside Google Cloud. For enterprise organizations with teams of VMware engineers, this breaks down any learning barrier to using cloud infrastructure. But of course, the trick here is that once you've extended your multi-cloud strategy to use Google's data centers, it's going to get harder and harder to justify the spend to keep your own DC up and running. In addition to the cost savings, running your workloads in GCP opens up access to other integrated services like cloud storage, BigQuery, and AI platform. Pretty soon, you'll be migrating all the things to Google Cloud. And why wouldn't you? Okay, with the end of all the great announcements, let's move on to my favorite section of the show, Guru of the Month. Congratulations to our GCP Guru of the Month, Darsh Bakshi from Mumbai, India. Congratulations, Darsh. We'll be sending you a swag pack, including a t-shirt, some stickers, and a hand-signed card. And why don't you see if you've got what it takes to be Guru of the Month? You could get your hands on all of those ACG goodies and be Guru famous. Check out this month's new question at the link below. Why aren't you clicking it right now? Who doesn't like swag? Well, that about wraps it up for another episode of GCP This Month. From all of us here at A Cloud Guru, I mean, not actually here in my house, that's just me, but from every other guru out there all over the world, we hope you're staying safe and we'll see you next time. Until then, keep being awesome.